Good night, good night, good night. Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining and welcome to another episode of Real Keys with Kathy Lloyd. I am Kathy, your realtor and financial coach. Tonight, we're going to talk about action, taking action towards your goals. So I hope, first of all, you're having an awesome week. The week is almost over, and I hope that you've gotten to accomplish all of your goals for this week. And so tonight, like I said, we're talking about action, and we're going to go through some real keys to help you take action on your goals now. So they're not going to be too cumbersome. They're going to be quite simple, but effective. So let's jump right in. And so our first real key is to turn your big goal into smaller goals. And this is the first key, because when we take on new things or we go back onto pursuing a goal, it can be overwhelming. And so this key or this action actually takes the overwhelming aspect out of your goal. So you're going to take your major goal and you're going to break that goal down into smaller goals. And small steps really make a big difference. And so if your big goal is to save $100,000 by the end of the year, and of course, we all know that we put some more parameters to that goal. And so you want to save $100,000 in your savings account by December 31st, 2021. And so you break that big goal down into smaller goals. So at the end of the day, you know how much money you need to save for each month. You know how many dollars you need to save for each week, each day. And you can actually go ahead and track those smaller goals. And it helps you feel more accomplished when you know that you're putting the effort towards something and you can actually see the results as you take each step. So that is our first real key when it comes to taking action towards your goals. Break your big goal down into smaller goals. And so our second real key is decide what is important. Because when you start to break your big goals down into smaller goals, you may have some goals that have time limits on them. So you know that by March 30th, you have to accomplish one goal, and that goal will help you move on to the next. So that one will be the most important. And putting these steps into a list of priority, we always talk about priority. And in order to maintain priority of that goal, you have to be consistent, you have to be intentional, and you have to go after it each day. And so you decide what is most important after you break your big goal down into smaller goals, and you go from there. The third key is identify the correct tools that you need to succeed. Now, this is very important because a lot of times we start a journey and we're unable to finish it because we don't have the right tools. So let's think about real estate. And if you read the blog for this week, I used a real estate example because it is quite relevant today, and many of my real estate clients come into the process and they are not sure what tools they need. And so getting the right tools in your hands and having the right documents, the right paperwork, the right information for your vendors, those are things that are important, and those are things that are going to make your journey a lot easier. And the next key is to stay motivated. Throughout your journey, you have to remain motivated. And all of the steps before this allows you to keep that motivation because you turn your big goals into smaller goals and then you're not so overwhelmed. The weight is lifted and it helps you to go through the journey a lot smoother with less anxiety. Then you decide what is most important. So you don't have your smaller goals just written down in any form or fashion. And when the deadline for one thing comes up, you missed it. And then you get into a panic and then it gets frustrating. No, you decide what's most important by creating a list of things that have a measure of priority. And that helps you to keep motivated because, like I said, it takes the frustration out of the process. And then identifying the correct tools also allows you to take the frustration and the anxiety and the distraught that can come with any goal that you're chasing. So take, for instance, you say you want to purchase a house. And then some of your smaller goals are you have to go in and choose a mortgage officer. You have to get pre-qualified. You have to choose a lawyer. You know that getting pre-qualified needs to come before all of those things because you actually have to know if you're in the financial position to go and start this journey. And if not, it allows you to revamp your goals, the smaller ones that is, in order to get to your goal of buying that house. So that also keeps you motivated because you have something to follow, you have a plan. And as we all know, plans change, but you still are taking action towards your goal and you're seeing your success and you can be proud of the things that you're doing. And so we talk about action today because we don't want our goals to just sit down, remain dormant, and we're not doing anything towards it. You put in the time, you put in the energy to actually sit down, create these goals, put some parameters behind your goals. And now it's time to go and execute the plan that you've created. And so you want to have a system. And that's where the list of priorities comes in. That's where the smaller goals comes in. That is where knowing what you need to do and what you need to have the right tools, you can actually create a checklist stating everything that you need to have in order to fulfill the first, the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth small goal. And it will be a smoother process, like I say, less frustrating, less anxiety. And overall, you will be able to see and celebrate your success along the way. So let's recap our real keys when it comes to taking action towards your goals now. So the first key is turn your large goals into smaller goals. And this key will help you to not be overwhelmed, not have all that frustration. The second key is decide what is most important. And this step involves creating a list, a priority list for your goals, giving some things deadlines, putting them within time frames, knowing what you have to accomplish by what date, knowing what step comes before the other. Then the third key is identify the correct tools that you need to succeed. And these tools can be, depending on what your dream is, the right equipment, the right documents, the right information, the right people. So identifying the right tools that will lead you to success. And then stay motivated because a lot of times, and I know for me, this week has been heavy because you sit down and you look and you're doing the things that you set out to do and you're tackling your goals. And sometimes it takes a bit longer for you to see the fruit of your labor, as it said. And so you have to stay motivated and those small steps will lead you to a successful journey and to accomplishing your big goals. So thank you for being here. Thank you for joining me. And remember, go out and take action on your goals now. Be prepared, be intentional, and go out and do what you have to do so that at the end of the day, you will say that you have achieved the things that you have set out to do. Thank you once again for watching Real Keys with Kathy Lloyd. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.